بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. In the name of Allah, the most beneficent, the most merciful, I testify that there is no true God worthy of worship except Allah, and that Muhammad is Allah's true slave and messenger. We continue the explanation of Surah Al-Kahf. This explanation is by our Shaykh Muhammad bin Salih Al-Uthaymeen rahimahullah ta'ala, and we have finished the story of Musa with Al-Khidr, and now we're going to move to start with the other story that came in this magnificent surah or chapter of the Quran, and that pertains to the story of Dhil-Qarnayn. This is a nickname of of this person whom we will try inshallah to define as to whom he is in the context of the explanation. But let's remember, yes, this surah 18, that his title is Dhil-Qarnayn. Let's go therefore to verse number 83. قال الله عز وجل ويسألونك عن ذي القرنين قل سأتلو عليكم منه ذكرا. Chapter 18, verse 83. Sister Ahmed, ready, inshallah. Sister Ahmed, are you ready? Are you having trouble with the sound still? Is she here? Or if not, then okay. I think she's having problems with the sound. Maybe Brother Abu Maher, could you take Brother Abu Maher, are you here? Oh, she's not here. Okay. Brother Abu Maher, are you here? Brother Abu Maher, please could you take care of the text if you are here? If not, Java console, could you help? Or Hamza online, could you help with the text inshallah? Verse number 83. Okay, Java, please go ahead. No, this is not Ed Shafiq. Omar is referring to something else. Brother Java is trying to help inshallah. Let's put verse number 83 from Surah Al-Kahf, which is Surah 18, verse number 83. And they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, verse 83 from chapter 18. Okay, I will continue inshallah. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ قُلْ سَأَتْلُوا عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا. And they ask you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, about ذُو الْقَرْنَيْنِ, say, I shall recite to you something of his story. Say, I shall recite to you something of his story. يسألونك, who are the ones who are asking the Prophet? Whether this came from the Jews or from Quraysh or other, but the question was related to as, who is this Dhul-Qarnayn? Dhul-Qarnayn was mentioned in history, and the Jews told Quraysh, the pagan Arabs then from the tribe of Quraysh, ask Muhammad concerning this man. If he tells you of his affair, of his story, then indeed he is a prophet. Now why he was called Dhul-Qarnayn? It is said that this refers to him possessing vast kingdom from the east and the west. And Al-Qarn, Dhul-Qarnayn, Qarn is like, okay, she's still having lag in the room. This is one side of something, the Qarn. is one side. So the east is one side and the Maghrib, the west, is one other side. Okay, take the posting. Brother Java, please continue. This is just similar to the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the east, when he said that afflictions come from the side of the east. حَيْثُ يَطْلُعُ قَرْنُ الشَّيْطَانِ, where the horn of shaitan appears. This is in Sahih al-Bukhari from the hadith of Abdullah bin Umar, may Allah be pleased with him and his father. He said, I heard the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saying on the pulpit, أَلَا إِنَّ الْفِتْنَةَ هَا هُنَا. In fact, the afflictions are there. Pointing, يُشِيرُ إِلَى الْمَشْرِقِ, pointing to the east. مِنْ حَيْثُ يَطْلُعُ قَرْنُ الشَّيْطَانِ, from where the horn of shaitan appears. And this has been explained by some of the companions to mean specifically Iraq. And subhanallah, most of the fitan, most of the afflictions came from Iraq, from that direction. Please take care of this nice to see. It is also said concerning this Dhul-Qarnayn that this refers to his powers, that this nick Dhul-Qarnayn refers to his powers, and that's why it is known that the ram caught the male of the sheep, end of quote, that possesses horns is of power. And it is also said that on his head, there were two horns like the crown of kings, like those on the crowns of kings. However, the closest to the Quranic meaning is the one who possesses the east and the west, and this is quite fitting, since we know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about the sun that it appears between qarnay shaitan. Between qarnay shaitan literally would mean the horns of the shaitan, but in the explanation of the hadith, this refers, as Al-Hafidh Ibn Hajar rahimahullah mentioned, that just a second please.